So Amanda and I opened Double Dutch Press in 2012. We both had gotten our printmaking degrees at the University of Georgia, our master's together. She finished up a year ahead of me. And we went off and did other things with our lives. Yeah, so we opened our doors in December of 2012, so we're just coming up on 3 years of a studio space in Athens. We do several things here at Double Dutch Press. So we offer workshops, which is really important to us. We both have a history of teaching and really enjoy letting people get to know how to printmake and what goes into printmaking as a traditional art making technique. And then we have a line of retail goods that we design and sell. And you can find us in our shop here. There's a retail section up front, and then we're carried by some different stores, and we go out to different makers markets and whatnot in the Southeast region. This example of Lauren's design is something we partner with Terrapin for every hop harvest and spring festival. They invite an artist to do a limited edition design, and we help produce the poster.
Well, my name is Lauren Geitner, and I got chosen to do the artwork for the hop harvest this year. And I was kind of challenged at first to come up with an idea because I really wanted to highlight the actual act of harvesting hops. Instead of just going with some really cool looking design, I wanted to incorporate the process a lot. And so I started out with a design of different hop leaves and different hops, all kind of bundled together in sort of a floral pattern. And that was kind of where I started. I then did some hand lettering and then scanned it into the computer and moved them around to make sense. And the promotional poster was literally a highlight of the hop growing process. So although it looks pretty abstract, it's actually a view from the ground up looking at how the hops are grown. So it took me a few different sketches to get to that point, kind of different angles to look at the hops being grown. And I landed on the kind of ant's eye view of the hop farm and had a few rough sketches in between. And this is kind of what I ended up with, which shows the poles and then the hops growing down, but it looks sort of abstracted in this way. And then I framed it with some similar hop designs as I used for the t-shirt design. And my whole point was trying to highlight how they're grown so that people who don't know can kind of be educated and get excited about hops and want to come celebrate with us. Well, my name is Lauren Geitner, and when I got chosen to do the artwork for the Hop Harvest for Terrapin, I started fumbling around with ideas and where I was going to go. And I actually started out with this design, and it incorporates a bunch of different kinds of hop leaves from different kinds of hop plants, because a lot of times in my artwork I like to feature different versions of the same thing. And so I kind of entered into the designs for the Hop Harvest in a similar way. So I started out with this one, and after that came the hand lettering, which was done by hand at first and then scanned in and reincorporated to make sense for the design. I'd say my biggest challenge was coming up with the promotional poster design, because after coming up with the t-shirt design, I wanted it to incorporate that but also be different in some way. And so I actually went through several sketches that were very architectural, because in my mind I wanted to highlight the actual act of harvesting the hops. And I ended up landing on a view looking up into the aisles of the hop gardens and hop farms that I was looking at. And so this was kind of the final rough sketch for this one. And if you can see, these poles are kind of the poles growing up, and then the sides are the hops falling down. And the wires are how they're hung. And then I wanted to kind of frame it using similar artwork that I used for the t-shirts. So my biggest challenge was trying to come up with a way to convey the process of harvesting hops without just drawing a tractor and a bunch of hops in buckets. So I tried to go with how they're grown, and from there I wanted to put it in a artistic context.